I was always acutely aware of the fact that I hadn't got a clue what I was doing.
Howard Jones wasn't the only solo act out of their comfort zone on Top of the Pops in 1984.
It was utterly terrifying. You know, I'm a guitar player and I'd spent the last 5 years playing guitar, and I play guitar in the studio, so obviously I'm going to go on television with a keyboard.
Exposed and alone on the Top of the Pops stage, with no mic and only a haircut for company, what you choose to wear can make a lasting impression. I got it bad.
You don't know how bad you got it. Don't talk to me about that snood. It kind of took on a life of its own, and it's literally been around my neck for my entire career. I could easily blame my stylist, but the buck stopped with me, really, because I did stand in front of that mirror and go, yeah, I'm going to go on national television looking like that. That's fine.
Two weeks later, Nick was back. And this time, the show had a trick up its sleeve.
I think the second time I did it, the production people kind of realised that actually there was nothing going on here. There's no great moves or anything. And so they stuck the video of the song behind me and kept cutting between it. Understand why they did that, yeah. The heat is stifling, burning
me up from the inside. Nick Kershaw and Howard Jones were the perfect pop packages for 1984. Big hair, fancy clothes, and a handful of catchy tunes.
We had this weird thing of the camera pointing at people that weren't actually singing the line. My favourite was Paul Weller being Bono. That was a nice moment. Well, tonight, thank God it's there,
instead of... But even before its release, Top of the Pops was playing its part in supporting the cause.
Bob Geldof's got a cardboard box with him, and it's full of T-shirts. And he just says, look, we're trying to get everybody to wear these Feed the World T-shirts. You up for it? I said, yeah, no problem at all.
Well, it looked better than the snood, Nick.